Hello students, today we will go through the third IoT application transport method, that is generic web protocols. So here the generic web protocols are very popular. It is because the programmers with basic web programming skills can work on IoT applications. So this will lead to innovative ways to deliver and handle real-time IoT data, and that's why it is very the use of these protocols are very high. For example, they have given that an IoT device generating an event can have the result of launching a video capture, while at the same time a notification is sent to the collaboration tool. So what will happen? This helps our technicians or the engineers to immediately start working on the notification or the alert message. For example, a general example you can take, that suppose if you have a company or a website that displays product information of that particular company, the site is accessed by the customers. So we have to make sure that the response time for any customer query is less than a specified value, for example 20 seconds or 30 seconds. So this should be possible even when there are many users, for example 200 or 300 users accessing the site simultaneously. So the response time should be very less. Okay, so this is one simple example of that particular scenario. So in general, IoT is greatly benefited from web-based protocols or generic web protocols, like for example HTTP or HTTPS and XMPP, which will help in integration of IoT devices in internet world through scalable programming techniques. So this topic is very small, and they can ask you a short note on generic web based protocols. Okay, thank you.